Just because you stopped, it doesn't mean the world did. My day starts at 4:30 at the depot, where Dave, who still believes in lizard people, has finally started to wear a mask. Rashid's off indefinitely, but that just means we're a man down, so we load up and we ship out. I deliver soap and sanitizer, canned goods and bread flour. I deliver organic hampers in Dulwich Village and wine subscriptions to Chelsea townhouses. I deliver bog roll under armed escort to Buckingham Palace. I deliver MPs to their mistresses in prepaid Uber Execs. I wipe down my surfaces. I deliver running gear and weight sets, yoga mats and ergonomic desks. I deliver succulents and eco-friendly sex toys to Herne Hill lesbians looking for revelation. I deliver Blitz Spirit via homebrew kits and mindful cross-stitch. I deliver textbooks and stationery sets to frazzled executive vice presidents suddenly demoted to homeschool enforcers. In St. John's Wood, a commissioning editor in a Liberty dressing gown offers me £500 to explain the properties of a sine wave. You don't understand, she says. They're always here. Can't you do something? Oh, you're so lucky. I deliver high-end dim sum to overcrowded Highgate dinner parties where on my way out, a crumbling chin slips me a crumpled 20 and asks if I know anyone to send a mate back with some Coke. I deliver sourdough pizza to illicit goldsmiths raves where would-be intersectionalists offer me a join and ask me to stay, saying, hey, well, I bet you can dance. I go, oh, look at him, I bet you can. Go on, show us how it's done. In the height of summer, I deliver crates of Rennie Adol Lodge and Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie and Audre Lorde to East London interlopers who pause to thank me personally but still don't tip. I grow tired of being asked, have you read this? In Hackney Wick, a tattooed Tarquin holds me hostage for 30 minutes with a pre-prepared statement on how he intends to be a better ally before finally dismissing me with a silent raised fist. Solidarity, bruv. By September, these conversations have stopped. I deliver CBD oil and lavender drops, weighted blankets and herbal remedies. I encounter a rake-thin zombie in Nunhead who mumbles, hey man, can I ask, are you sleeping? My cans of Red Bull fill the footwell until I receive a written warning. This is the company's vehicle, not my personal toilet. I piss into an empty Lucozade bottle in a lay-by off the M25. I keep going. I send A-grade sexts to Jess, a Tinder match, who, through our cultivated misunderstanding, thinks I'm a paramedic. She messages me every Thursday to say she's clapping for me. I like that. You know, why not? I spot a status update from Josh, who's feeling hashtag blessed, wants to remind us all how rare it is that we all get to stop, or take stock, reprioritize. He was approaching burnout before, but now he's energized. Sometimes some breathing space is all we need. No time to reply. You know, the world didn't stop because you did. 86 drops left till I hit my daily target. Maybe next year I'll get to catch up on all that growth you got while I was out here. Now, can you sign for this?
The days and weeks, oh, they go by. I find it hard to reason why.